Recording in progress.
Hello.
Hey,
Hey, are you able to see my screen at all?
I can see you and I can hear you now. Yeah, I
Can
can see.
you see my screen?
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, yeah. This is what I was talking about with the Law Hub. If you're on the website, this is what you have access to. It's all the prep test materials. So it's gonna be like the prep test 93, which is the latest one. And it has the all the other ones as well. So if I click on the newest one, this is gonna be the June 2020. This is
Do you
what,
think there's
yeah, this is what you kind of get. You get the LSAT prep test, and if you pick a section, it will just give you the information in this kind of layout. Like this would be the article right here, and then these would be the questions to the article.
similar to the actual exam, right? How they show.
Yep, it's like the actual exams, like you said.
Right. Do you think that you're going to get the same questions on this exam from this exam, or no? Or
Yeah,
very similar?
all the questions are gonna be similar. Like, have you tried the logic game at all for the new prep test?
Haven't been, I'm not registered. Maybe I'm registered, but I haven't done anything from like the Kaplan. I think they register at them automatically, maybe, but I have.
Yeah, exactly. You should get it registered automatically. If not, just go on the website. It's kind of like the way like the exam's gonna be during the or during the orientation or the exam day.
And you practice through this kind of every day, right? Okay, so this is similar to Kaplan, logic games, whatever. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. I kind of practiced this similarity. And with this one right here, it's kind of straightforward. Like this one's gonna be a logic game with the corporate playing two travel itineraries, two representatives, F and G. Sometimes if I have trouble with the layout or how they originate, I'll look at the answers here, and this is how they originate for F and G. So for F and G, let's see if I can just write it here. It says that each of them who must visit three of the following cities: Houston, Montrose, Seattle, and Toronto. Each city must be visited by at least one representative, and at the most by each representative. The following additional conditions apply to the itineraries. So for the first one, anyone who visits Montrose must visit Toronto immediately after, so that's going to be MT. And usually with that right there, you can just go through the answers and see if you see it or not. Like here we see M, then we see a T, that's okay.
Exactly.
Yeah. Here we see M, but we don't see T, so that's not okay. So we take that out.
Yeah.
And here we go. Here
Are
we
you
see.
going by the rules? Like, are you eliminating through the rules, or you're just,
Yeah, the way I do it, the first condition, and then I apply it right away. So for this one right here, anybody visiting Montrose must visit Toronto
Exactly.
immediately after. I don't read all the conditions and then get a good understanding and then go ahead and solve it. I kind of apply it right away. So for this one right here, like anyone visiting Montrose must visit Toronto immediately after. Here's Montrose, but here's Toronto before, and that's not okay. Now, if Gloria visits Houston, so if G visits Houston, then Frank must visit Montreal. So if Gloria visits, here's Frank must visit Montreal. So with that one right there, we're gonna go ahead and look for it where Gloria's in Houston. And here she's in Houston, but Frank is not in Montrose, so that's not okay. Gloria's in Houston, Frank's in Montrose, that's okay. Now here's the next one. If this is Houston, then he must visit Seattle later. So basically, if Frank visits Houston, Frank must visit Seattle later. So now we're gonna look for it where we see Frank in Houston. And here we see Houston here, but we don't see Seattle, which is not okay. So we're left with this final answer, D. And that's gonna be the correct answer right there.
How do you see them like when you, oh, it's green, and
Right.
that's how you see it's correct, yeah?
Yeah, now what I like to do too, that's gonna help me out a lot, is I like to copy the correct game piece board, just because that's gonna help me out with the additional questions. So here I have it copied, and this is a good sample with that meets the following conditions here. Now,
Right, because it can help the furthering questions, right?
I don't go through the questions in order. I don't go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I kind of look for the easiest one. Like for example, this one here says which of the following could be Frank's itinerary. That's broad. That's really too much data right now. It's not really specific. It's not really a detailed question. Frank and Gloria each visit Montreal. That's actually better. That's actually more detail. So I can go ahead and apply that right here that they visited Montrose. And we already know that anybody who visits M has to visit T. So I'm gonna make two worlds for this one. And then I'm gonna put Montrose here, T here, T here. And then if Gloria visits Houston, Frank visits Montrose, that's correct. So we can put here, and then we put with Frank, we could put Seattle. We can't put Houston because if we put Houston, we have to put Seattle, which we only have room for only one. So with that being said, based on this world right here, then which of the following could be true? Houston is the second city visited by Frank. I do not see that anywhere. Take that out. Houston is the second city visited by Gloria. I don't see that in both worlds. Take that out. Seattle is the first city that Frank visits. So I see that here in this game piece right here. That is the correct answer. It is this first city, and that could be true. So we go ahead and choose it, and the answer is correct. Now, to go like same thing to this question four, if it's not really too much detail, it's kind of broad, too much data, so I'm gonna go ahead and skip it. And now we have question six. If the second city Frank visits Seattle, so what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna put two game pieces, two worlds, and I'm gonna put Seattle in the second. Montrose, I'm gonna put in the bottom here. Montrose, I'll put the bottom. Also, I'll put Houston here, Houston here, and then I'll put Houston here, Houston here. Then I'm gonna put T here just because of if M goes there, you have to apply T, but if you just apply T, that's okay. So now I have two worlds right here. And this is question one right here. This is question three. And this is question six. So this question is asking, if the second city Frank visits Seattle, then which of the following must be true? The first city Frank visits Montrose, that's not true. The third city Frank visits Toronto, that's actually yeah, we actually have that to be true right here. That is true. So with that gonna say, we're gonna go and just pick it right now. And we got it correct. Now, with these three worlds that we created, we can go ahead and go back and answer the questions that we haven't solved yet. Like question five. Which of the following must be true? Frank versus Houston. That's not true here. Frank versus Mount Royal. That's not true here. Gloria versus Houston. That is true. Gloria does visit Houston, as you can see. There's Houston here. Just like it's a highlighter. So that's true. So these two are not okay. This is okay. Gloria visits Seattle. That's not true. Gloria visits Toronto. That seems to be true with H. With that answer, you're not gonna be able to put M. If you have M, it includes T, but you can include T by itself. So you are allowed to have T by itself. And that's actually going to be what you consider mandatory, because if M's not down here, then M's going to be up there, which means T's going to have to go down here. So that one's going to be T. And the reason that's going to be T is just because of the mandatory that if M is shown, then T has to come in, but T can actually be by itself. For the rest of the questions, I'm just going to use the worlds that we created. If T is the first city that Gloria visits, so I don't see this anywhere. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to create it really quickly. The F is here, G is here, and then T is going to be the first city that Gloria visits. So T here. So I'm going to put T H. Actually, I'm going to put S. Then here I'm gonna put T H S, and this meets the conditions that anybody who visits M has to go T. If H is with Gloria, then M has to be Frank, and if H is with well, actually, yeah, this one actually meets what you consider the standards. This one's actually appropriate. So it wants to know which of the following cannot be true. Frank visits Houston, that's not true. Frank versus Montrose, that seems to be true. And just to make sure, sometimes too, if I have trouble, I'm gonna make just two game boards, just two worlds. That way, I can just make sure that everything's correct. S T. Oh, actually, we could do H, S, and then we could do T, and then we could do S, because if we put H here, then M has to go up there, which is not going to be up. It doesn't meet. So we have two game pieces now. So Frank versus Montrose, that's true here, but not here. So take that out. Frank versus Toronto, that's true here, and that's true here. Gloria versus Houston, that's not true here. Gloria versus Seattle, that seems to be true as well. But I'm trying to see, it doesn't have to be a requirement. It can actually be what you consider H. And that forces I'm here.